Okay, so Jose, first of all, tell me, coming out of retirement, this was a very special fight for you in many ways, actually. So perhaps can you explain, you know, a bit why and how?
It was a hard time for me. A year ago, I lost a special friend that I met on the street. He was homeless, so we had a good connection. You know, we used to see each other every day. Then, you know, without I realized, he passed away. You know, I always be involved with the homeless, but I didn't know how bad it was until I'm in the shoes of people that lost their lovely ones. So I realized how painful it is. So I came back to give to the homeless what I should have given to him. So and keep them safe in certain way, the way I can help.
You know? And you were surrounded by many fans and your children and your family. Does that make it a bit more special for you?
Oh man, that was, you know, unexplainable. I can't explain the feeling of having all those people shouting, loving, vibrating. Yeah. You know, the support was like the best energy I ever had. Yeah. You know, the best feeling I ever had, the best title I ever had as well. So I always come to give them what they want, to make sure they spend the money and they get quality. So it's always overwhelming, their support.
Well, Jono, you fought him twice before. So as far as your preparation went for this, you know, it was familiar territory, but did you do anything different in preparation?
I did a lot of things different. But in the end of the day, you know, Phil always prepares really well. And this time he was more focused on all of us. So I was off for 2.5 years. So I was really feeling really confident coming to this fight. I didn't really care about the win or lose. To me, even the 2 times I won, still nothing to me, you know, because it's all about the crowd anyway. So as we did again, we made the crowd come alive. So we both won the fight. So he was the better man today. He took the victory. Congratulations to him. He showed why he took the victory. He stood with me. We fought. He hurt me. I hurt him. And the end of the day, we still love each other, respect for each other. Don't matter how much we hate each other for the preparation of the fight, yeah, as we're fighting, but after the fight, it's all about love and respect because we need to keep this sport alive.
Wise words. With the last fight today, what is that inspiring you to do? You know, do you see yourself fighting again, or what are your plans for 2020?
Make world champions. That's what. And I need to make world champs. I've done everything I have to do. If I maintain myself in the game, I'm being greedy. It's space for other new people to come, shining. And, you know, as you guys saw today, I did what I have to do for the crowd. The more they love me to come back, I got a team that I have to look after. So I have to dedicate all my passion, my life into my team for them to come in and take this crowd away from me and keep this crowd in them, so this crowd will still live in me.
So after such an amazing career, what advice do you have and what motivation do you have for some of the youngsters that are watching and are getting into the sport?
I will be rude on this.
Go ahead, man.
You young people, stay away from Instagram. Yeah. Instagram fighters, respect the sport. Stop disrespecting the sport. Like today was a lot of fights in here. Stop that. We come over here because of you guys. So make sure you guys bring a respectful crowd. You guys respect each other. Talk whatever you want to talk. Hit each other up before the fight. But in the end of the fight, show that love, because we need to keep this sport alive. If you guys keep on disrespecting, putting bad vibe into this sport in the social media where young people will see it as well, this sport will die. You know, so keep this sport alive, respect, because inspire the new comers to come in. And now this sport is not about killing each other or hating each other. It's about grow and make other people grow, make other people understand everybody can do it. Because certain people, if they see bad vibes, they will be afraid. You know, make them feel welcome to come in and do what we do and be loved. I just want to say, you know, listen, I'm retired. Anybody that want to fight me, take that out of your mind. Leave me alone. You know, and I want to say a special thank you to Bloodline Gym, that's where I start. They take me far. They made me the pit bull I am. Fight Zone for always make me wise, keep me in shape, keep me mature. They teaching them and be part of that team. I grow up so much. I know that how important this sport is. Team 2, a special team. Phil, I thank you so much for make me grow, make me reach and achieve all of this. Without this team, I wouldn't. The team I call Team 2, I call the $1 million team. You know, they special. You know, they open their arm, they welcome me, they gave me everything. So it showed today why I'm this person as well. So also I want to thank my boxing coach we've been together for 10 years. He always been by my side, helping me, pushing me forward, come out of his way to train me, to prepare me for fights. My kids, my fans, everybody, my family, everybody that was behind me, I thank you so much. All these years that you guys inspired me to be who I am and to grow in this sport and to be more mature. And you guys are doing a good job as well. So always
words from a true champion.
A pleasure to come and speak to you guys. Love.